guys, welcome back to your party. The theme for this episode is YouTube. I filmed this episode last year in my last day working at YouTube, but I faced a lot of issues uploading it. But it's finally here and I hope you like it. To make the cupcake toppings, I need white and red fondant. I used a tiny heart shape cutter to cut the white fondant heart shape instead of the triangle. And then I cut the red fondant into rectangles. And then I rounded the edges to get the play button shape. And then I glue one of the heart shape fondant using a little bit of water. And here are the toppings, they turned out super cute. It's time to assemble our cupcakes. I prepared the toppings already. I prepared 24 mini red velvet cupcakes. And I prepared white buttercream. Pipe the buttercream and add the toppings. I prepared 3 rectangular red velvet cakes. I used the parchment paper as a guide to find the middle and cut them in the middle. I used some buttercream to attach the cake to the cake board. I put some parchment paper in the sides just to protect it. And then stack the layers of cakes to make 6 layers of play button shape cake. Cover the whole cake with buttercream, chill it, and then put a second coat. Using red fondant, I covered the entire cake to look like a play button. I then cut the extra fondant and smoothed the sides of the cake. And then trim the excess with a small knife. Using white fondant, I cut 2 triangles for the front and back of the cake. And this is our final look of the cake. I decided to cut the cookies in a circle shape to make them emojis. I covered the cookie dough with plastic wrap and then cut it using the circle cookie cutter just to get the dome shape. And then I made a bazillion of those! This is how the cookies look before and after baking. You know you can make the black and white cookies using those? Just use the other side. These are the fondant I used to decorate the cookies. I also added pink and baby blue. I also used the white and red for the cake and for the cupcake toppings. And I used some icing to glue the fondant on the cookies. I also covered the fondant with plastic wrap before cutting it. And using the icing as glue, I attach the fondant onto the cookies. And then repeat that a bazillion times. To decorate the cookies, just use your creativity. I actually had this idea in mind before to make special or custom-made emojis for YouTube. One-eyed alien emoji YouTube logo thingy. So I made some of those, and for the rest of them, just the colors for YouTube. And they look just like the regular ones with two circle eyes or, you know, closed eyes or whatever. Regular emojis, different colors. The mistake I made while decorating these cookies that I used water as a glue. I wouldn't recommend it because it makes it tacky. So you should use either alcohol or vanilla extract or whatever extract you have because it evaporates, which is great. And this is my final collection of emojis. As party favors, I decided to give away charms that I made out of polymer clay that look like magic wands, because I'm a magician and I do magic and I love magic. And I made them using the colors of YouTube and decorated them with the play button, which I eventually forgot to give away. But if you guys like those and you want me to give them away, please let me know. Leave me a comment below and maybe we should do a giveaway. So that's how I added the parts for the charms. And as a final touch, I placed them individually inside mini teeny tiny Ziploc bags. And this is how they look. Super cute. So tiny, my zoom couldn't even catch them. Or my camera is bad. And this is my final setup before the party. I also performed some magic. Some of them need spectators, so I couldn't include in this video. And I added one of them to this video just because I can. Are you guys ready to see some magic?
Yeah!
A lot of people asked me, what did you do when you worked at YouTube? I was deleting bad comments. Keeping the platform safe was not an easy task, because every time we delete the comments, they keep coming back. We take them down, and they come back again. We take them down, but they come back. And no matter what we do with the comments, they keep coming back. We delete the comments, and they come back again. We take them down, and they come back. We take them down, and they come back again. But that's not the only thing I did at YouTube. You see, I also delete misleading thumbnails. Misleading thumbnails is a big deal at YouTube. Every single channel has at least one misleading thumbnail. There are misleading thumbnails all over YouTube. But that's not the only thing I did at YouTube. Because you see, the most important thing are the videos themselves. Thanks for watching. If you like my content, subscribe to my channel and tell me what themes you want me to do next.